The Summer of Smash unofficially comes to a close this weekend at Shine, where some of Melee's best are looking to add a few more wins to their resumes before we move into the fourth and final quarter of 2019. So to see what storylines, potential upsets, and exciting sets you should be looking out for in New England, let's work our way through winner's side of Top 32 match by match. But real quick before we do that, this video is sponsored by Metagame. Metagame provides esports mental coaching, is led by Louis Lima's PhD. Louis is a longtime competitor and tournament organizer, most notably for the Full Bloom series. If you struggle with things like tournament nerves, negative self-talk, work and life balance, or team communication, then you should definitely set up a free 30-minute consultation. Contact Louis at his email or on social media, both which are down in the description. And with that taken care of, we start again with a bit of a dud of S2J facing off with the MDVA Peach Polish, in a set that S2J will certainly win. And unfortunately, with the lesser depth of talent here at SmashCon, we'll be seeing a lot more of these foregone conclusions, so we'll try not to spend too much time on them in the future. Next, we got Hax facing off with the HBox Slayer Albert. For just about any other Fox who has peaks at Hax's level, this would be a no-brainer to say he'd win, but Hax has had some pretty bad losses this year, most recently to Wisp at SmashCon, so there's a non-zero chance he loses here. But Hax is up 2-1 on Ginger and 1-0 on Magi in 2019, so logically he should win here. Esfet is another player who's been known to drop some questionable sets sometimes, like he did against Kevin Maple's Fox at SmashCon, but Icy's isn't really a character we see him getting upset by, so he should be able to hold it down against Boyd. Ginger vs. Spark is a great draw for Spark, who has time and again shown his proficiency against Falco by upsetting West Balls once a year for the last 3 years. These two have also met twice in bracket in late 2018, the first at the Mango Homecoming in a grueling Game 5 set won by Ginger, and the second time at one of the stacked parking lot locals, where Spark handed Ginger a quick 2-0. So it could go either way, but my money is on Spark solely for the fact that he's almost certainly been studying these VODs, because I was only able to find footage of their Homecoming set, as well as a money match the two played, because they were self-recorded and uploaded to Spark's own YouTube channel, which shows he's such a dedicated player. If Spark does pull off the upset, he's got Esfet next, who 2-0'd him at the Roast of Hugo, so his potential for a deep run looks pretty bleak. But even bleaker would have been New England native Joyboy and his Fox's chances against Leffen if he didn't recently announce on Twitter that he most likely won't be entering Melee at Shine because of scheduling conflicts competing in multiple games. So this most likely means Joyboy advances from this point, and with Leffen's place moving forward in the bracket, we'll briefly discuss what it would be like if Leffen does compete, but we'll mainly focus on the alternative. This brings us down to the next door neighbor seed match between Rishi and Lucky. The two showed off exactly why Marth Fox is a Melee classic when they met in losers at Super Smash Con, where Lucky won in Game 5. Seeing this does give Lucky the slight edge, but he's nowhere near being considered the huge favorite with the laundry list of Marcy's drop sets due this year, which includes Stango, Jagan Shaken, and Shroomed. Next, we've got the highest seeded New England native, Slox, set to play a Fox Ditto against Fiction. Both players haven't put the best head-to-head records against the Foxes located close to them, with Slox being a combined 2-6 against Hax and KJH, and Fiction being a combined 3-4 against Lucky and Mike Hayes. The Fox Ditto is known to be one of the most swinging matchups, so hopefully Slox will be able to bring home an upset for New England to potentially move on to another Fox Ditto against Moki. That is, if Jagan Shaken isn't able to add another Fox to his 2019 hit list. Moki hasn't been able to attend any large out-of-region events since Summit due to personal reasons, so will almost certainly be a bit rusty at Shine. Jake did lose the crunch as Fox 2 weekends ago at SmashCon, so it looks like there may be a bit of rust on both sides, which leads me to believe that Moki will hold strong at his first event as a top 20 player. We then move on to the second half of the bracket, where Bobby Big Balls will be trying to do his best Albert impression against a newly riled up HBox who has lost his number one seed for the first time in quite a while. Lot is coming off his deceptively average 4th place showing at SmashCon, with the only top 100 wins he got were both against Amsa, which are great, but Peach is notoriously a hard matchup for Yoshi. So now against Mike Hayes, he's got a chance to remind us that studying to become a doctor doesn't magically erase your Melee skill. The two haven't met since 2016 where Mike Hayes won both of their sets, but this was back when Lot was 54th best in the world and Mike was 28th, so this is another match you're going to want to watch out for because it can go either way. But whoever wins this will be met with a reality check of Hungrybox in the next round. Kalvar is also coming off a win of his own at the New England Melee Invitational, where he beat the region's top players as well as a handful of newcomers to take home gold at the Summit-like event. Bringing this momentum to Shine is good, but it'll be hard to take out Swedish Delight, who beat him the last time his Sheik met Kalvar's Marth in 2017, and whose Falco was even able to take a game when they met at the Gang in 2018. For Pew Pew versus Dreffen, there's not much recent historical data to go off of, as the two haven't ever faced off in bracket, and both players haven't been tremendously active this year. But with Dreffen getting 3-0'd by Jake and Shaken when they met this year, Pew Pew should take the set no problem. Then Plup is basically an unwinnable draw for Hugs, who's been slowly slipping down the seeding slope at every event he attends because of performances like his 33rd at SmashCon losing to Rishi and Bones. So let's hope that Hugs is at least able to finish as projected at Shine, so we're still able to see his name on the top 32 seeds thread. And after Trudeath's quality run at SmashCon beating Axe and Mike Hayes, it looks good for him to grab another top 30 win against KJH, who he hasn't ever played in bracket, but who is a player who has been known to struggle against lower level ICs like Boyd. On top of showing his expertise in the Jigglypuff matchup by beating Hungrybox, IBDW has also defeated Legend 2-0 way before his rise to the top in 2017 at Shuffle, so Legend shouldn't be much of an issue for Cody. And after finishing off this first round of winners, we have another Puff, Toussaint, set the duel against Captain Faceroll. The two have met a single time before in 2018 at Genesis 5, where Faceroll took the set 3-1 to knock Toussaint out of it. So with Faceroll's rise and Toussaint's relative stagnation since then, Faceroll is for sure the favorite to advance on in bracket, but he hasn't really gotten much experience playing against high-level Jigglypuff this year, besides a close set against Michael at House of Pain 20, so Toussaint might be able to flip this with enough prep work. That then brings us to the next round of winners with a match I really hope we get to see, EsterJ versus Hax. These two haven't played in bracket in 5 years, all the way back at MLG Anaheim, where Hax's newly converted Fox lost to EsterJ in a touch of poetic justice. So the character matchup is still going to be the same since their last meeting, but the controllers and the players are much, much different. As for EsterJ's recent history fighting Foxes, 3-3 with SFAT, 2-0 on Moki, 1-2 against Fiction, 3-0 over KJH, and 4-2 on Lucky, bringing it to a total of 13-7. Hax unfortunately doesn't have the wealth of data points that EsterJ has, but notably it did take Wizrobe the game 5 at the script, so he could totally do it. All of this uncertainty makes this one of the can't miss matches of the weekend for me if it happens. SFAT and Ginger is another match I'm excited to see. Falco versus Fox is one of, if not the most entertaining matchups in the game, and seeing these two titans of their character face off will certainly be a treat. The two haven't played in nearly a year since SFAT won 3-1 at GTX, so hopefully we'll get to see if Ginger's level up in that time has shrunk the gap enough that he'll be able to pull off the upset. And with the win there, Ginger could go on the run of his life with the bracket ahead. He'll be looking for EsterJ the win in the previously discussed match, as he won their sole meeting this year at Summit, but having Hax, who is only 1-2 on for the year, isn't bad of a secondary option. Both are very winnable for the bird, and would place him all the way in winner's semis. If Levin doesn't drop out, he'll most likely get crushed by him here. But if not, he's likely going to have Fiction, Moki, Rishi, or Lucky. Fiction would easily be the most exciting with how often the two beef on Twitter. The pair have most recently met in bracket at Show Me Your Moves 19 where Ginger won, but in their first of five $300 money match back in April, Fiction won in dominating fashion 5-2. So this would be the dream winner's semis. Ginger would also be pretty excited if it ends up being Moki, as he swept him the last time they met at Summit when Moki was still in the super flow of grinding the game. Rishi not so much so, as he hasn't been able to beat his Marth when they've met in bracket, but Rishi would also have to pull off a crazy run to make it there. And last is Lucky, who is more on the unfavorable side of Ginger's choices, having them split 2-2 sets for the year. So I think there's a realistic shot we see Ginger finishing 5th or higher at this event, which is something that feels like a long time coming with how dedicated he's been to the game, especially over the last couple of years. The next round is a bit odd to talk about because it could be any of the four combinations of Leffen or Joy Boy versus Rishi or Lucky. But if Leffen competes, he should easily handle whoever stands in his way. And if it's Joy Boy in that spot, Rishi or Lucky should be able to dispatch him, but maybe he'll go on a godlike run of his own. Fiction versus Moki is yet another sick match to look out for in this round before winner's quarters. Both are super talented and explosive foxes, and they haven't met since the parking lot local in 2018, where Fiction did 3-0 the Canadian handily, but even if this match is one-sided in Fiction's favor, the fox ditto never disappoints. But what almost certainly will be disappointing to watch, and very likely won't be streamed, is Hungrybox versus Lod or Mike Hayes. Neither of these players have ever beaten HBox, and I don't think it'll be changing at Shine. Swedish versus Pew Pew is a match that we've gotten to see a lot over the last 3 years, with Swedish being up 5-3 all time, as well as winning the last two at EVO 2018 and the Mango. So the Sheik is definitely the favorite to continue on in this bracket, but their history has been swings back and forth, where Swedish will win for a stretch, and then it will swap over the Pew Pew winning, so maybe he's finally able to turn it around at Shine. But whoever takes it has Hungrybox next, which has been someone both players have taken games off of in the past, but not someone we'll probably see them beating. Plup facing off against Shudet should be another easy win for Plup, who most likely will be bringing out his Samus for this matchup, which will be sufficiently warmed up from him soloing her at SmashCon. And closing off this group of matches, we've got IBDW meeting with Captain Face Roll. The two haven't met according to Tapo stats, but with Cody being up 3-1 on Swedish Delight's Cheek for the year, and Face Roll being down 0-3 to SFAT's Fox, IBDW will most likely be walking away with a W from this set. Starting our winners' quarters, we've got S2J versus SFAT, which I don't really think is worth taking too much time to talk about. Not for the fact that I don't think it'll be a great set to watch, but solely for the reason that they're 3-3 for the year, so honestly, I don't have any idea how this set is going to play out. Not having Leffen in the immediate path does make this set a hell of a lot more interesting though, because these guys aren't fighting for a better spot in losers now, but instead a run to winners finals. And if SFAT is able to win it like he did last time at Smash and Splash 5, he'll be hoping that he gets his optimal draw for the Fox Ditto between Fiction, who he's up on 3-1 for the year, Moki, who is down 0-1 for the year, or Lucky, who is up 4-2 for the year. The only real chance for him in winners finals is if IBDW pulls out the nuts run and beats both Hungrybox and Plup, but somehow isn't able to have the endurance to beat the veteran SFAT, who's even with on sets for the year, and we somehow see a CLG win at Shine, which may be the only way a Zane victory from last year can be topped. And we again see how wild a top player dropping out of an event can make a bracket when we get down to Rishi or Lucky facing off with Fiction. If it's Rishi, Fiction advances on, having dispatched a much more practiced Rishi at the Big House 8 and Don't Park last year. If it's Lucky, well, we've got the potential for yet another player to have a shot for a run the winners finals, as Fiction is down 1-2 against Lucky this year. So then Lucky would have S2J or SFAT in winners semis. Both are doable, and it's hard to say who we'd rather see. S2J is Lucky's number recently, double eliminating his Fox both at Puyo Pound and Skissum, but Lucky is up pretty strongly all time, 43-31 according to Tapo stats. On the other hand, he's beaten SFAT the only time they met at the Mango in 2019, but SFAT has had a pretty firm grasp of their head-to-head, beating Lucky 7 out of the last 10 times they met. So with all these moving parts, I don't have a clue what's happening on this side of the bracket. However, I do know that Swedish Delight has a next to zero chance of beating Hungrybox in a best of five set, as we previously discussed. The last of our winners' quarters matches is Plup versus IBDW, which could prove to be a critical breakpoint in the careers of both of these players. Cody's beaten HBox, Mango, Zane, and Amza all this year, which is insane by itself, but adding Plup on top of that too would almost certainly push him past S2J, and potentially even past Amza for the ranking. If he kept that run going, beat Hungrybox again in the match after that, and then went on to become the Shine 2019 champion, he might even be past Plup. Zane passing Plup, Amza being up 3-0 on Mango, and all the other crazy upsets we've had this year have really shown that literally almost anything can happen in Melee, but if IBDW wins Shine, I honestly can't comprehend that happening, but it's so much more likely than you think, and it would be such a crazy moment for Melee. But coming back to reality, because we've been getting to have a little too much fun with this video because of how wacky the bracket is, Plup has swept Cody's Fox the two times they've met in bracket, so even though he's been underperforming all year, Plup should have this. So there's absolutely no way for me to talk about our match on the top side of winner semis because of all the harebrained theories that we discussed. We could have Rishi, Lucky, Fiction, or Moki playing against S2J, SFAT, Ginger, or Hax. So let's have a little fun. Make a prediction down in the comments of which two players you think will most likely see meet up here, as well as which two players you would want to see the most, both of which I honestly think are really hard answers. But if you're missing the consistency we once knew in Melee, you'll be relieved to see Hungrybox versus Plup on the other side of the bracket. Plup has lost 11 straight sets to HBox, which include 5 losses this year, 2 3-0s, 2 3-1s, and a singular 3-2 at Genesis 6. So Plup needs to find that fire he once had against his fellow Florida native, or the Puff main is just going to continue to run up the score. And with how whack the top side of bracket is, we're going to talk about winners finals in terms of how well the general field of players could potentially do against the big three contenders from the other side of the bracket, Hungrybox, Plup, and IBDW. I know it's not what a lot of you want to hear, but if Hungrybox makes it the winners finals and Leffen isn't there to meet him, he's probably winning Shine. Six of the field are Spacey's players, which Hungrybox should have no trouble dispatching, and S2J and Rishi have nowhere near the expertise in the matchup that Wizrobe and Zane do. Maybe someone could double eliminate him from loser's side of Grands, but only a handful of players have ever been able to do that since Hungrybox's rise. And honestly, I think the same sort of story goes for Plup if he's able to upset HBox. In his slump, Plup has settled into his role as a gatekeeper to the top, and if he's finally gained enough confidence back to beat HBox, he's not going to be losing to the field. The only way I don't think he wins Shine if he's on winner's side of Grands is if HBox is able to reset the bracket from loser's side. If he takes the set 2, I'm very, very scared for Plup. And if IBDW makes the run of his life, he will surely be playing extremely hot. But he's dropped sets just this year to a lot of players that could be facing him on the other side, so that makes him the key for us to get a truly ludicrous Shine 2019 winner. As for his prospects for winning the event, the same goes for him as it does for Plup. If HBox resets the bracket in Grands, he's almost certainly a goner, but Cody can, and hopefully will, win Shine 2019. And that about does it for this video. Let me know about which matches you're most excited to see this weekend, and which players that I wasn't able to talk about that you're most excited to see play. New England is such an insanely talented region, so one or two of them will almost certainly mess up these projections by pulling off some upsets. And again, thanks to Metagame and Louis for sponsoring this video. If you're interested in getting coaching, check out their links down in the description. And that about does it for me. I've been Saves Untitled, and I will see you guys next time.